But one of the greatest contributions that Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has made is the discovery of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's birthplace. When he started going through the texts of left by Lord Chaitanya's associates, so he came to know, because after Lord Chaitanya disappeared, Ganga, which it keeps changing its course. So after the Lord disappeared and his associates disappeared, Ganga changed its course, and for 400 years, this part of the land where we have ISKCON temple and Mayapur and birthplace and that entire track was under Ganga, underwater. And after 400 years, again it started receding, and because it was time now for the Lord Chaitanya's teachings to manifest again and spread. So through his studies of the maps, ancient texts, he understood. And when Ganga was covering this whole place, the other side of Ganga, which is today known as Navadvip town, there people had started claiming, they still do, that this was Lord Chaitanya's birthplace. Because when you claim that this is Lord Chaitanya's birthplace, naturally you will draw tourists and more donation would come. So they had started claiming this was, and for so many hundreds of years, this part was considered Lord Chaitanya's place of appearance. But he understood it has to be on the other side of Ganga. But he was not able to figure out the exact spot. So one day, he was in Navadvip, standing in the balcony of Rani Dharamshala. And on the other side of Ganga, he saw kind of light which was touching the sky, lighting up the entire area, coming out from a particular spot. He understood this has to be the birthplace. When he went there, he saw enormous growth of tulsi plants in that spot where he had seen the light coming from. And he understood, he got some intuition that this is the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya. He had studied the maps and now he was able to experience it, but still he wanted to verify. And at that time, the leader of the Vaishnava Samaj was Srila Jagannathas Babaji Maharaj. At that time, he was almost 120 years old, and he could not even lift his eyelids. He could not open. Somebody, his servant Bihari, had to come and lift his eyelids so that he could see who was in front. He was always engaged in bhajan. He had to be carried in a basket. His servant Bihari would carry him everywhere. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur had accepted him as his guru, and he decided to get him to this spot and get it verified, because he knew Srila Jagannathas Babaji Maharaj was a Vaishnava of the highest stature. So Bihari brought him in a basket, and as soon as they came to this spot, Srila Jagannathas Babaji Maharaj, who could hardly move, he would be lying down like this with his head almost into his legs, bent completely because of old age. But as soon as they came to this spot, which Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur thought was the birthplace of Lord Chaitanya, he brought Jagannathas Babaji Maharaj for verification. Jagannathas Babaji Maharaj jumped from his basket 15 feet high and he started dancing also. He could not even lift his eyelids, but he started dancing. And he started saying, Eito Nimaya Janbhumi, Eito Nimaya Janbhumi. And he was dancing in ecstasy, and Bhaktivinoda Thakurji was in ecstasy. And now this was verified. Now the next challenge was to revive this place, because this is the birthplace of the Yuga Avatar. Not just Yuga Avatar, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is considered the essence of all avatars. And he comes only once in a day of Brahma. So this is the most holy spot in the creation right now. And it is explained, as the Kali Yuga progresses, all the other holy places will hide their potency. But the potency of Mayapur will continue to grow. This is the holy place for Kali Yuga. As Kali Yuga will expand its influence, Mayapur will also expand its influence. Mayapur is specially created, Lord Chaitanya's movement is specially created to counteract Kali. And as Srila Prabhupada said, Nobody can stop Lord Chaitanya's movement. Even Maya Devi does not have the power. We just have to be careful. He said, only way this movement can be restricted is if we start fighting amongst ourselves. Otherwise, nobody has the power. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur also has predicted, a time will come when all the religious movements of the world will come under the banner of Sankirtan movement. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, just to revive this place then, he went from place to place, from house to house, collecting 1 rupee each. He personally went as a beggar, because for the Lord's service, we are all beggars only. And there should not be any harm in begging when it is for the service of the Lord. There should be shame when we are asking something for ourselves, but not for the service of the Lord. And there will be people who will reject, may not understand, but that's all right. All kinds of people exist in this world. So he went from house to house, collected 1 rupee each, and then he built a small temple at Yogapeet. And later on, his son Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, whom he prayed for, because he was struggling, he was doing it single-handedly. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur single-handedly revived Lord Chaitanya's teachings and his movement and brought the credibility back amongst the educated class especially. Otherwise, they were spoiled. So single-handedly, he did that. And it's not a not an unusual thing, because Devki Nandan Thakur, who happened to be Gopal Chapal, in his bhajan, Vrindavan Vasiyat Vaishnavirakan, he writes that one devotee of Lord Chaitanya can deliver the whole universe. So he has that much potency. So Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur was one such devotee. And he built a temple and he was praying to Krishna that, please send me one of your associates to expand your mission. I cannot do it alone. And Krishna answered his prayers, and he had one of his sons, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, appear when he was residing in Jagannath Puri. And it was Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur who took this movement to another level. And he was the one who then revived this, or expanded, or made a beautiful temple in Yogapeet, which happens to be Lord Chaitanya's birthplace. And as they were digging, they also found one small deity of Vishnu, Adhokshaja Vishnu, and which was the same deity which was worshipped by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's father Jagannath Mishra, and it is still there on the altar. And Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur's contributions were so great that he was given the title later on, the seventh Goswami.